I like to say that oftentimes in abstract algebra, the only thing that even makes sense to try is often the right answer. And so I hope you thought of the only thing that makes sense to even try here as far as coming up with an isomorphism here. We're trying to prove that if G and H are groups, that the external direct product of G with H in this order is isomorphic to the external direct product of H and G in that order. So to do this, you would have to come up with an isomorphism. Define a function phi from the external direct product with G and H to the external direct product of H with G. By what formula? Oh, how about phi of G comma H is H comma G. Only thing that kind of makes sense to even try, right? I hope you thought of that. And then the issue is this really an isomorphism or not? Is it one-to-one onto an operation preserving? So let's go ahead and see if we can prove those things. One-to-one, we think it probably is. Assume, let's say phi of G1 comma H1 equals phi of G2 comma H2. By the way, if you didn't do double parentheses like I'm doing, it's okay. But I am trying to emphasize the outer set of parentheses are for the input for the function phi, and the inner set of parentheses are for the ordered pairs in these external direct products. The goal then would be to show that G1 H1 and G2 H2 are the same, right? If the outputs are the same, the inputs must have been the same. Assuming this based on the formula implies that H1 comma G1 equals H2 comma G2. In other words, H1 must be H2 and G1 must be G2. So if you do switch around the order of the components of the ordered pairs, you still get equality. G1 comma H1 equals G2 comma H2. Right? Does that make sense? Is that what you did? Smile. Hopefully that's what you did. On to, give me an arbitrary element of the codomain given H comma G in the codomain of this function. What gets mapped to it? I hope that's pretty clear. It's G comma H. It's almost too easy. Therefore, phi is onto. I should have said, therefore, phi is one-to-one up here. So the only thing left is now to show that phi is operation preserving. That one might be the trickiest one, but it shouldn't be too hard, I think. Let's say G1 comma H1 and G2 comma H2 be ordered pairs in the external direct product of G with H. What do we need to show? We need to show that phi applied to the quote unquote product of these two ordered pairs. And this is abstract group theory, so we are multiplying them, so to speak, unlike with what we usually think of with ordered pairs as being vectors where you add them. I mean, if the operation were addition, if we were talking about true vectors in the usual sense here, we would use addition in here as the operation, but this is abstract, so we don't have to. What is the definition of what it means to multiply ordered pairs? It means you all multiply component-wise, or if they were true vectors in the usual sense, you would add component-wise. Formula for phi then says switch the components around. And then, well, you could also simplify phi of this times phi of that separately, but you also could just do this all in one line here effectively. You could write this as how do we want to do this? H1 comma G1 times H2 comma G2. And that is phi of G1 comma H1 times phi of G2 comma H2. Once again, to the uninitiated, like your parents, if you showed this to them, they'd be like, what kind of gibberish are you doing, right? But it does have meaning in math. This tells you something. It tells you that these things ultimately are isomorphic because we've come up with an isomorphism. And that tells you could figure out in the homework that you handed in whether certain groups are isomorphic or not, and that helps you classify groups and that kind of thing. So it is a useful thing within the context of group theory. QED or PTL, praise the Lord. Okay, we're done.